Okay, we have now an example of a bioreactor. And under steady state conditions, that means that we have a reactor with some conversion in it. So we have a conversion of substrate in a bioreactor into biomass. Let's draw a sketch. The tank is well stirred, and here we enter a certain liquid flow with a certain concentration of substrate and a biomass concentration which is zero in the inlet. We also add a little bit flow rate to adjust the pH, which we call the pH volume flow rate, and the total volume flow rate is leaving here the bioreactor and contains a certain concentration of substrate and a certain concentration of biomass. And the question is, in this vessel, substrate is converted into biomass, and the question is, what are the conversion rates of the substrate and the biomass? Well, to set up this balance, we have to look into this vessel, which has a certain volume, and let's look first at the substrate. So we put a mass balance on the substrate, and we put a mass balance on the biomass. In both cases, we can derive, under steady state conditions, the conversion rates RS and RB. Well, let's start with the substrate. The change of the substrate as a function of time is equal to the amounts of substrate entering the bioreactor minus the amount of substrate which leaves the reactor minus the amount which is converted, RS. Well, because this is a steady state situation, this term is zero. And the only unknown in this equation is now the conversion rate RS. So if you now substitute the values given in the example, you will see that the conversion rate is equal to 0.04 grams per hour. Well, in a similar way, we could derive the conversion rate of the biomass. Well, let's do that at this side. The change of biomass as a function of time is the amount of biomass entering the system minus the amount of biomass leaving the system plus the amount which is produced in the bioreactor. Well, there's no concentration in the inlet, so this term is zero. We also deal with a steady state, so this term is also zero. Well, now we only have to substitute the values we already know, and then we get a value of RB, which is equal to 0.26 gram per hour. So you see in this example that you also, if you have a reaction, chemical reaction in a vessel under steady state conditions, you can calculate the conversion rates in the vessel. Well, thanks for your attention.